I said we didn't need any new constructs, but we are going to introduce one, and that's going to make writing the code we need for our search engine much more convenient. It's also going to be very useful for lots and lots of procedures that we'll want to write. And the construct we're going to introduce is called a loop. It's a way to do things over and over again. The kind of loop that we're going to introduce first is called a while loop. The syntax for the while loop is this. We have the keyword while, followed by a test expression, followed by a colon, and then inside we have a block, and the block is a sequence of instructions. This is very similar to the if statement. So as a reminder, here's what the if statement looked like. We had an if followed by a test expression, followed by a colon, and then an indented block, which is a list of statements that executes whenever the test expression evaluates to a true value. With if, the block executes either 0 or 1 times, depending on whether the test expression is true. With while, the block can execute any number of times. It keeps going as long as the test expression is true. So with an if statement, if the test expression is true, we go to the block, run the block, and then continue. If the test expression was false, we go right to the next expression. With a while, we also start by checking the test expression. If it's true, we go to the block. But now, instead of going to the next statement, after the block, we go back. We try the test expression again. If it's true, we go back to the block. We always go back to the test expression. If it's true, we do the block again. We go back to the test expression. If it's true again, we do the block again. We go back to the test expression. And we can keep going around as many times as we need. As long as the test expression is true, we'll keep executing the block and keep trying the test expression again. At some point, maybe the test expression is false. Once the test expression is false, we go to the next instruction. So this means a while loop can execute the block either 0 times if the test expression was false at the beginning, 1 time if it was true the first time, but false after that, 2 times, 3 times, any number of times. It could keep going forever. There's no requirement that guarantees the test expression eventually becomes false. So here's an example while loop. We start by initializing the variable I, and we'll give it the value 0. Then we have the while. The test expression says I is less than 10. So that means as long as this evaluates to true, we'll evaluate the block. And what the block does is print I and then add 1 to I. So here's what happens when this executes. So initially the value of I is 0. I is less than 10. So that means we'll enter the loop. So that means the test expression is true. So we'll enter the block. We'll print I. So we'll see the value 0 printed. And then we'll do the assignment. So that will change the value of I. We add 1 to I, so that's going to be making the value of I now refers to 1. So if it was an if, we'd be done now. But because it's a while, we keep going. We go back, test again if I is less than 10. Now the value of I is 1, which also is less than 10. So we continue, go to the block again. We're going to print I. This time we'll see the value 1. Then we go to the next statement. Increase the value of I by 1. That's going to make the value of I 2. Now I refers to the number 2. Because it's a while, we keep going. We go back to the test expression. I is less than 10. Still less than 10 because now it's 2. We're going to print the 2. We're going to add 1. That'll make the value of I 3. And we're going to keep going. Do the test again. 9 is still less than 10, so we're going to print I again. We will print the value 9. Then we add 1, so that's going to add 1 to 9. We'll get 10, and so that's the new value of I. And we go back again. And now we do I is less than 10, and now I has the value 10. 10 is not less than 10, so that will be false, and we're done with the while loop. We'll continue with whatever statement is here. In this case, there is none. So at the end of the loop, what we've done, we've gone through it 10 times. We've printed the numbers from 0 to 9. The new value of I will be 10. If we do anything here that uses the value of I, we'll see that the value of I is 10. So to see that you understand while loops, we'll have a quiz. So the question is, what does this program do? Here's the program. We start by assigning 0 to I. We have a while loop where the test is not equal to 10. So the test is I is not equal to 10. Then we have I equals I plus 1. So we're assigning to I the value of I plus 1. And then we're printing I. So this is similar to the example, but different in a couple ways. So it's up to you to see if you can figure out what the program does. Try to figure it out yourself. You can certainly also try running this in the Python interpreter. The choices are produce an error, print out the numbers from 0 to 9, print out the numbers from 1 to 9, print out the numbers from 1 to 10, or the final choice is it runs forever, or at least until our machine runs out of power. So see if you can figure out what it does. You can definitely try running it, but try to figure out on your own before running it in the Python interpreter.